eBay is the biggest online auction site. You can buy anything on it, from used dentures, broken calculators, designer clothes, cars, and everything in between. The site is so big that at any given time, there's an estimated 800 million items for sale, some of which are ridiculous, yet worth a fortune. Here are 10 of the stupidest things people have paid a fortune for on eBay. Number 10, guinea pig armor. Yep, you heard right. The next time your guinea pig heads off to war, it needs to be dressed for battle. Is your pet guinea pig tired of wandering around the house unarmored and vulnerable? Asks eBay seller Sean McCoy from Fairfax, Virginia. Apparently, he bought the helmet already made for his guinea pig, Lucky, but unable to find a chainmail outfit small enough, crafted one himself. Sadly, little Lucky passed away, leaving Sean to find a new home for his tiny suit of armor. The original winning bid reached a staggering $24,300, only for the bidder to back out. It later returned to eBay and was sold for $1,150, with all the money going to the Metropolitan Guinea Pig Rescue. That might be pretty far off $24,000, but who else thinks $1,150 is a lot of money to pay for your guinea pig to play dress up? Number 9. A camera used by Usain Bolt. No, this camera didn't exactly belong to Usain Bolt. It was just temporarily stolen by him for a few moments before he etched his name into the body with a screwdriver. When a Swedish photographer, Jimmy Wickstrom, snapped away photos of Usain Bolt after he won gold for the 200 meter at the London Olympics, the last thing he expected was for Bolt to grab the camera out of his hands. But that's what happened. Wickstrom said the athlete then shot a few photos of fellow athlete Johan Blake and the crowd before scratching his name onto it and handing it back. Wickstrom then listed the camera on eBay, where it fetched $11,600, with the money going to charity. It's a cool collectible, but is it really worth that much? I mean, regular Nikon DV cameras go for around $1,000, and this one was scratched. Number 8. Coke cans. If you love spending your money on Coke, the drink, not the substance, then you might know that Coca-Cola collectors flock to eBay for rare empty cans that are being sold for as much as $11,000. Due to a factory error, some cans have been produced and leave the factory with either nothing inside or just a little dribble of the drink. For most of the world, this doesn't rev our engines. But for the diehard collectors, a factory error is almost as rare as a unicorn. So these cans have become highly desired throughout the community. One that weighs 14 grams, which is about 400 grams less than a normal can, is even on sale online for around $14,000. But what's dumber than paying tens of thousands of dollars for an empty Coke can? Probably finding one and then ruining it so you can't sell it would be a whole lot more stupid. This happened to an unsuspecting mother in Bristol, England, when she bought a multi-pack of the beverage and stumbled across a near-empty can. As she filmed herself opening the tab, she poured out a measly 3 drops before asking what the hell was going on. But a quick online search soon gave her the answer, and she soon discovered she destroyed a rare can worth around £15,000. Number 7. Andrew Fisher's forehead. In a bid to help pay college tuition, Andrew Fisher decided the best way to raise funds would be to sell the use of his forehead to the highest bidder. He says, "The way I see it, I'm selling something I already own. After 30 days, I get it back." So who exactly did he sell this unique space to? After a well-publicized auction on eBay, he sold out to Snorstop for $37,375 and got their company logo temporarily tattooed on his head for 30 days. In case you were wondering what his mother thought, she said she thought the aspiring young entrepreneur was thinking outside the box. So what is the pioneering forehead advertiser doing these days? According to his own website, popmalt.com, he's winding down and doing some soul searching. He's also dipping his toe into other ventures, including producing a Hollywood movie. But he admits he's not entirely sure it was all worth it. After Andrew Fisher's peculiar claim to fame, other people followed suit, giving birth to the whole forehead advertising phenomenon, with one poor guy getting a radio station's name tattooed on his face for a fortune, only to discover it was a practical joke. Ouch! So what do you think? Do you think it's worth a fortune to tattoo your brand's name on some kid's head? Number 6. Crash debris. When Prince Philip's Land Rover pulled out of a country lane near Sandringham, Norfolk in January of 2019, he crashed right into a car containing 2 young women and a 9-month-old baby. Despite overturning his vehicle, he remained unhurt, unlike the occupants of the other car, who suffered bumps, scrapes, and even a broken arm. Of course, royal family lovers flocked to eBay when they discovered pieces of the crash were up for sale. "It may even have Phil's DNA on it if you wanted to clone him," said the seller. Whether people wanted to create their own Prince Philip or not, bidding reached over £65,000. Funnily enough, the eBay post said the listing didn't even include the glass. It was just for 3 plastic parts. Still, there was a huge controversy over the crash as Prince Philip didn't apologize for many days after the accident, even though it was his fault. He didn't see the oncoming car because of the bright sun, although many people, including the victims, disputed that it was sunny that day. Many have argued he should have his license revoked, as his old age and eyesight may be impairing his judgment. Whatever you may think, at least the money from the crash went to charity. Number 5. Justin Bieber's milk glass. Are you enough of a believer to buy a dirty milk glass? Well, someone is, because in 2016, after the star popped into a local pub in Essex, England during his Purpose tour, a member of the bar staff swiped the glass. After immediately putting it on eBay with a starting bid of 99 pence, it reached an incredible £66,000 at closing. The seller, who served Bieber salmon, mashed potatoes, and a glass of milk, insisted it hadn't been washed and promised 10% of the money would be donated to an Essex animal charity. I don't know what's weirder. The idea that someone was dumb enough to pay around $80,000 for a dirty milk glass, or that Bieber, an internationally famous artist and party animal, went to a bar and ordered a glass of milk. Number 4. Royal Wedding Hat. When 22-year-old Princess Beatrice attended the wedding of Prince William and Kate Middleton in 2011, it was hard for people to ignore her choice of headwear. Her hat, made by Philip Treacy, came under harsh criticism from viewers of the royal wedding, with some people likening it to a turkey twizzler, while others went as far as saying it resembled a toilet seat. But somebody had to like it, because a month after the wedding, it found its way onto eBay, where it sold for a whopping £81,100. That's around $106,000. So far, the buyer has remained anonymous, while all of the money was donated to 2 charities, UNICEF and Children in Crisis. Whether it looked like a toilet or not, at least it raised some money for a good cause. But the peculiar pretzel-looking hat isn't the only royal wedding memorabilia to have made it onto eBay. Just 3 days after Prince Harry married Meghan Markle, his gift bags from the big day started creeping onto the auction site, with one fetching £21,000. Some things included inside the canvas bag were a bottle of water, a fridge magnet, a tin of shortbread, a spectator badge, and a parking sticker. Do you think that's worth over $21,000? I mean, the water wasn't even Fiji water. Number 3. An entire life. That's right. After a messy divorce, Ian Usher took the idea of a fresh start to the extreme and decided to sell his entire life. That included his house, job, car, jet ski, motorbike, and even some of his friends. Apparently, Ian said he couldn't cope with all the reminders of his failed marriage, and therefore, everything had to go. Within days of the auction starting, Ian received worldwide publicity, and eventually, his whole life and everything in it sold for $399,300 American dollars. So what did Ian do once he sold his life? With no debt and no roots, he simply packed up and went traveling around the globe living the high life, even buying his own Caribbean island. Not only that, but he managed to find love again and sold the rights of his story to Disney. It seems dreams really do come true. But would you pay hundreds of thousands of dollars to buy someone else's life? It seems like there are maybe cheaper ways to run away from your problems. According to Reuters, the winning bidder remains anonymous, with the username MSLMCC. Number 2. Sniper's Window. On a site where the odd and extraordinary are often sold, it's no surprise that bidders will stumble across the occasionally macabre object. One of these was the window from which Lee Harvey Oswald shot President Kennedy in 1963. This piece of history was apparently removed from the building shortly after the assassination, after members of the public kept turning up to steal pieces of it. It later fell into the hands of a local family who placed it up for auction. Bidding began at $100,000, but reached an impressive $3 million and was sold to a mysterious buyer who has remained anonymous. But is it actually the real window? Some conspiracy theorists have claimed the window is a fake and that the entire building was bought by a man from Tennessee decades ago, who removed the window himself and took it away with him when he left the city. What do you think? Do you reckon some lucky bidder bought a unique piece of history? Or were they simply swindled out of a sweet $3 million? Number 1. Lunch. Okay, this isn't any ordinary lunch. This is the chance to have a unique power lunch with the original Oracle of Omaha, Warren Buffett. Every year, a San Francisco nonprofit Christian organization holds an eBay auction in which they offer buyers the chance to have their very own business lunch with one of the world's richest men. The winner can attend the Smith & Walensky Steakhouse in New York with up to 7 friends and can only bid once they have been approved by eBay. So how much are one of these lunches? Well, the average American spends around $1,000 a year on buying lunch, but the last Warren Buffett eBay auction in 2018 fetched just over $3.3 million. That better have been some good steak. So what magical wisdom does the Oracle of Omaha share once you buy your way into one of these lunches? Two men who bid for the lunch date in 2007 and won after bidding $650,000 said they learned 3 things: that they should do what they love, be comfortable with saying no, and that they should have integrity. I can't help but think they could have just learned that through buying a $10 self-help book instead. So would you have bid on any of these things? Or does the idea of owning Justin Bieber's used milk glass not do it for you? Let me know in the comments down below. And thanks for watching.